verses 1 through 10.
고린도후서 12장 1절에 10절을 교독을 하도록 하겠습니다.
And we'll have responsive reading.
무익하나마 내가 부득불 자랑하노니 주의 환상과 계시를 말하리라.
I know a man in Christ who 14 years ago was caught up to the third heaven, whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know. God knows.
내가 이런 사람을 아노니 그가 몸 안에 있었는지 몸 밖에 있었는지 나는 모르거니와 하나님은 아시느니라.
And he heard things that cannot be told, which men may not utter.
내가 이런 사람을 위하여 자랑하겠으나 나를 위하여는 약한 것들 위해 자랑하지 아니하리라.
Though if I should wish to boast, I would not be a fool, for I would be speaking the truth. But I refrain from it so that no one may think more of me than he sees in me or hears from me.
계시를 받은 것이 지극히 크므로 너무 자만하지 않게 하시려고 내 육체의 가시 곧 사탄의 사자를 주셨으니 이는 나를 쳐서 너무 자만하지 않게 하려 하심이라.
Three times I pleaded with the Lord about this, that it should leave me.
나에게 이르시기를 내 은혜가 네게 족하도다. 이는 내 능력이 약한 데서 온전하여짐이라 하신지라. 그러므로 도리어 크게 기뻐함으로 나의 여러 약한 것들에 대하여 자랑하리니 이는 그리스도의 능력이 내게 머물게 하려 함이라.
For the sake of Christ, then I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamity. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Amen. Let us bless each other, be at peace. You're the missionaries to save the world. Let us enjoy the inheritance of the desolate heritages. Do you truly love the Lord? God knows the heart, your heart, which loves God. And the Lord will abundantly fill us up. And He will make us go on His path.
저항할 수 없는 주의 은혜로 충만해지는 그런 축복의 예배가 되기를 주의 이름으로
I bless you that the Lord may this worship become the worship where you receive all of the blessings that are irresistible.
우리가 인생이 이게 무엇인지 헷갈릴 때가 많이 있습니다.
So at times as we live on, we are confused.
이렇게 살아가는 것이 과연 잘 살아가는 것일까 그런 의문들이 들 때도 많이 있습니다.
And we sometimes think, oh, am I living the correct life?
열심히 살아간다고 살아가는데 뭐가 뭔지 모르고 인생이 자꾸 꼬이는 이런 부분들도 또 오게 될 것입니다.
And at times you try to live a diligent life, but things keep on getting twisted up.
최선을 다해서 살아왔는데 어느 날 내 인생에 허무함과 공허함이 찾아올 때도 있는 것입니다.
And at times I thought I was doing good, but chaos and void come inside of us.
혹시 이 한 날에 이 자리에 앉은 여러분이 정말 내가 무엇을 위해서 살아고 이제까지 무엇을 위해서 살아왔는지를 생각해 볼 수 있는 그런 시간들이 되었으면 좋겠습니다.
I really hope that may this time be the time where you truly think about how you lived your life.
또 귀중한 답을 말씀을 통해서 찾음으로 말미암아
And through finding all the precious answers through the word,
주신 능력들, 응답들을 누리며 살아갈 수 있는 그 축복 가운데 세워지기를 주의 이름으로 축원합니다.
I bless you in the name of the Lord that you find all of the blessings that God is trying to give you inside of the word.
인생에 있어서 인생의 문제들이 꼬이고 꼬여서 인생이 무엇인가를 답을 얻지 못하고 살아갈까요?
Why are we living the life where everything gets twisted up and problems? Keep on continuing.
여러분에게 어느 순간 어느 날부터인가 불편해져 있는 기도 때문입니다.
It is because of the prayers that has become uncomfortable to you and confusing.
우리의 인생이 무엇을 위해서 살아가는지도 알지 못하고요.
It is because of the prayers that we are doing, we live the life where everything gets twisted up.
내가 뭔가를 한다고 하지만 어느 날 찾아오는 허무와 공허함 속에서 빠져나오지 못하는 것.
And because of the prayers that we have lost hold of, we keep on falling into confusion, chaos, and void.
하나님의 말씀을 말씀되게 하는 것이 기도입니다.
Prayer is what makes the word of God become the word. And making God become God is through prayer. Yes, God is Alpha and the Omega. He is the first and the last. He is the eternal God. And He existed long before we even existed. And He is eternal and vast God. Even though we do not acknowledge God as God, but He is God. Even though we do not believe in the Word is the Word. But through the grace of God, when we are able to pray, inside of our lives, we are able to see that God is God and the Word of God is the Word of God. Because we are not able to enjoy prayer, that is why the Christianity is being mocked at. Let's take a look at Ezekiel's 36. Verses 37 through 38. Let us all read together. Thus says the Lord God, this also I will let the house of Israel ask me to do for them, to increase their people like a flock. Like the flock for sacrifices, like the flock at Jerusalem during her appointed feast, so shall the waste cities be filled with flocks of people, then they will know that I am the Lord. Hallelujah. Even though we do not pray, the word is the word. And God is God. But through prayer, we are able to know that I am the Lord.
Abimelech 이삭에게 찾아왔습니다. 창세기 26장에 보면은 지난 날은 아비멜렉이 이삭을 쫓아보냈는데 다시 이삭에게 찾아왔습니다. 그러면서 28절 29절에 아비멜렉 아브라함의 이삭에게 무엇을 하라고 말씀했는지 아십니까? 하나님이 너와 함께함을 우리가 분명히 보았다. 우리가 우리하고 합친하자.
So
한마디로 말하면 손잡자 한 것이죠.
Abimelech he comes to Isaac and said, "Let's join together."
하나님께 복을 받은 자다.
And then he says to Isaac that you are the person, Abraham, that you are.
하나님 하나님 되어짐으로 말미암아 하나님의 영광이
are filled with the Spirit of the Lord.
실제로 응답받지 못해서 기독교는 현장에서 조롱거리고 조롱거리가 되어 있다.
Realistically, right now, Christianity inside of the field, because they're not able to receive answers, they're being mocked at.
그러면 응답은 무엇일까요?
Then what are answers?
내가 얼마만큼 무엇을 해서 오는 것이 아닙니다.
It's not something that comes because we did so-and-so things. There are people who do not receive answers even though they prayed. And there are people who receive answers even though they did not pray. So I'm not trying to tell you that, oh, because we prayed this much, I received this answer.
내가 무엇을 또 어떤 일을 어떤 봉사를 했기 때문에 기도 응답받는다라고 생각할 수 있습니다.
Many people come to a misconception that because they did good deeds, charity work, and that's why they receive answers.
확인된 데서 응답이 온다라는 사실을 아셔야 됩니다.
We must know that what is imprinted inside of us, according to that, we receive answers. There are people who are in the midst of sadness.
이미 그 속에 슬픔이 각인되어 있어서 그래요.
It is because that they are in, sadness is imprinted inside of them. And there are people who are always angry.
오래 남을 용서 못하는 가거된 분노가 내 속에 자리 잡고 있기 때문에 그런 겁니다.
It is because that they have the long-standing anger that were which they are not able to forgive others is decided, imprinted inside of them. Then what happens if thanksgiving and joy is imprinted inside of us? Then things that we are able to give thanks and enjoy yourself will arise inside of our lives. So it doesn't matter of our daily lives. It is what is imprinted inside of us, and regardless of the environment, what is imprinted inside of us is important. So without us knowing that with the things of the world and the things that is opposite of the gospel, these physical things are imprinted inside of us. And when healing takes place from that, we are able to receive answers. So whatever the circumstances or in the environment, we are able to have victory when we are able to pray. Today's passage we all know so well. So you're able to see Paul with the physical disease that he had, he pleaded to God. But it shows us what he did, was there before he started to pray. So to Paul, he had this physical or spiritual experiences first. And this, he could not speak in the words of man. And he has this mystical experience that he could not even speak of. And after having this experience, this spiritual experience, he held on to his disease and prayed. So we must think oppositely. If we are caught with a disease where we are able to die, or about to die, if the word of God and the gospel, if this is not organized inside of us, then we are not able to pray. Many of the Christians, when they're faced with a problem, they try to pray, but if the word of God and the gospel is not organized inside of them, they cannot continue to pray. That is why when the believers are faced with a problem, they fall into complain, resent, and they go up against God. So they do not perish because of the disease. It is because they have lost hold of God. That is why they fall into failure. That is why we must quickly organize. We must discard the unnecessary things. Because we discard those things, we do not perish. Rather, because we are not able to discard, we are not able to communicate with God. And though we might be able to communicate with the people of this world, but because we are not able to communicate with God, we are not able to receive the answer, the blessings that God is trying to give us. But opposite, though we might not be able to communicate with the people, if we are able to communicate with God, we are able to receive all of the blessings. We must take a look at it. Because of the communication that we are having with the people, at times block the blessings that God is trying to give us. For me, I'm not that fit inside of society, and I'm not able to stand before people.
뭔가 사람들 앞에서 싫은 소리도 하는 거 쉽지 않아요.
And I don't like saying bad things in front of people.
사실은 쉽지 않아요.
And I can't really say that, oh, let's go together. It's not an easy thing for me.
오히려 하나님과 소통하는 시간들을 가지고 있음을 보게 됩니다.
But because of those things, I'm able to communicate with God. So take a look at your walk of faith. I'm not saying that we do not need to communicate with people.
그게 하나님의 통하는 통로의 축복과 가로막혀 있다면 축복이 가로막혀 있다면은 사실은 그 사람과의 소통은 필요 없는 것이죠.
But because of the communication with other people, if that is blocking the blessings that God is trying to give us, then that is unneeded.
그러니까 그분이 저한테 그런 이야기를 해요. 목사님 괜찮아요. 사람과 잘하는 거 그게 무엇이 필요합니까?
I told this one person about how
그 말 한마디인데 제가 참 위로가 되고 힘이 되었어.
I'm not able to fit in with the society, but and this person said that doesn't really matter. So if something is blocking you from receiving the blessings that from God, you must quickly discard all those things. I really hope that you truly have communication with God. What is prayer? It is the greatest gift that is given to those who have received salvation. It is the greatest gift where we are able to communicate with God.
전도도 내 삶도 모든 것도 사실은 다 끝난 것입니다.
So if you're able to truly pray, then realistically, my life, evangelism, everything, it is finished. Mankind are spiritual beings, but are we inside of God or are we inside of Satan? So are we leading, being guided by the Holy Spirit or the evil spirit? Am I inside of the gospel or am I inside of this world? According to that, answers come to us. So first, so the greatest blessing that is given to those who have received salvation is prayer. But what happens if we lose hold of prayer? I could tell you many things, but we will fall into three things. If prayer does not take place, we become lethargic. Because we have to live with our own strength.
내가 창조주고 능력 있는 사람이면 다행이야. 능력 있는 사람이라면은 괜찮겠습니다.
If I am with a person with power and if I am the creator, it doesn't matter. But all mankind have limitations.
내가 일단 무기력에 빠지는 것입니다.
That is why because we have to live with our own strength, we become lethargic.
가장 위대한 발명품도 유통 기간이 있습니다.
Even the greatest product that is made has expire date.
It's same for people.
If people live with their own strength and not with the power things of God, that is absolute impossibility.
그래서 사람은 기도 없으면은
That is why people, if they are not able to pray, they become lethargic.
자꾸만 쓸데없는 것에 집착하게 되는 것입니다.
And they become obsessed over the useless things.
것인데, 자꾸 쓸데없는 것에 집착하게 돼요.
If you just leave it alone, it will be solved. But people are obsessed over that.
90%는 거의 가만 놔둬도 다 지나가는 문제라고 이야기합니다.
The problems that come to mankind, if you just leave it alone, 90% of the problem, 90% of the problem is finished. But it's just the 5% of the problem that we're not able to solve. But because we do not have the strength of prayer, we fall into obsession. Concentration and obsession are two different things.
찰나에도 집착에 빠지는 것이 아니라 집중하게 돼 있어.
Those who live inside of prayer, even in that brief moment, they're able to pray and concentrate.
있고 살 수 있는 순간에 어떻게 하냐에 따라서 우리가 하나님의 인도를 받게 되는 것을 보게 됩니다.
So if you see in the Bible, in that brief moment, we could die or live. And
느헤미야서의 느헤미야 1장 2장에 보면은 느헤미야가 절대 위기 가운데 빠지게 되었어. 그래서 느헤미야가
아수에로
왕 앞에
And you're able to see how he fasted and prayed.
예루살렘 성들이 해파된 부분을 놓고 기도하면서 금식하면서 아수에로 왕 앞에 느헤미야가 나가게 되었습니다. 금식했다는 말은 무슨 말입니까?
What does it mean that he fasted?
이스라엘 백성들의 멸망 상태를 놓고 집중했다는 말이죠.
It means that he has concentrated in prayer because his people were about to perish, and you're able to see answers come from that. So even in midst of crisis, they are receiving answers. Now the king commands Nehemiah. He says, "What happened to your face?"
아수르 왕이 네 얼굴이 왜 그렇게 근심이 가득 찼냐 물었습니다.
So the king asked Nehemiah because his face was filled with worries. So what happened to your face?
백성들의 상황과 무너진 예루살렘 성에 대해서 이야기했습니다.
And that's when Nehemiah speaks to the king and says that my people will be perished.
느헤미야에게 가서 성전을 회복할 것을 말씀하고 있는 것을
And the king tells Nehemiah to go restore the temple.
바울은 죽을 병에 걸렸다라고 이야기했습니다.
And Paul, he was faced with the disease that could kill him.
가지고 나가는 사실을 보게 됩니다.
But there were no answers, but he was able to receive this solution and go out.
바울은 기도 속에서 보게 되는 것입니다.
So inside of prayer, Paul was able to see these great works.
자신의 육신의 질병을 놓고 간절하게 세 번이나 기도했다고 했죠.
You can see Paul earnestly prayed and he pleaded to the Lord three times. He concentrated in prayer. But he was able to see the great things that God has given us, the grace of God that was given to him. So without us knowing, because we do not pray, we fall into obsession. And we fall into obsession, and now that becomes an addiction. So right now, it is the age of addiction. It is the age of mental illnesses. We have lost hold of all of the fourth industrial revolution. And in the fifth industrial revolution, everything will perish. With great development, mankind will perish. And many spiritual problems will arise.
어떤 면에서 정말로 우리가 치유에 대한 부분들을 눈을 열지 못한다면은
If you are not able to open up our eyes to healing, then we are not able to relay the correct gospel inside of the field.
우리 교회도 전문 사역국이 지금 준비되어서 지금 사역들 하나하나 진행해 나가고 있어요.
And we have this many of the departments inside of the church that are being prepared.
하면서 시스템이 되어지고 있는 부분을 보게 됩니다.
And regard During healing, there is a system that is being prepared. So now we are heading into the age where if it is not the gospel, we are not able to heal those people who are addicted. And we have the Onesimus ministry and healing ministry that is taking place.
우리 청소년 그 아이들을 보호하는 그런 쪽에 가서 사역하는 또 교도소에 들어가서 사역하는 이런 분들 중심으로 해서 오네시모 사역이 진행되고
So we have the Onesimus ministry that is taking place where we go to the juvenile kids and help them out.
교회에서 실제적으로 이 중독 시대 예방을 위해서 구체적으로 이제 사역을 하기 위해서 팀들이 기도 가운데서 이렇게 만들어지고 있는 것을 보게 됩니다.
And regarding healing, we have also a team that is being formed inside of prayer.
대한민국에 보호 감찰소가 58군데나 돼요.
Now we have in Korea alone.
교도소가 53군데나 돼요.
53 prisons.
물론 범죄자들도 있지만은 많은 중독자들이 들어와서 치료를 받게 됩니다.
As many criminals are in there, but many people who are addicted are also in there as well. So they need to hear the gospel. That is why the churches are preparing this system.
지금 어떤 면에서 보호 감찰로 들어가서 실제적으로 마약이나 이런 모든 부분에 예방하고 또 치유하고 제어하라는 이런 부분을 놓고 지금 기도하면서 시스템이 준비되고 있습니다.
그래서 so inside of the headquarters, they are trying to prepare the system where we go to the people who are inside of probation and inside of jail so that we can help them with the gospel. I told you before.
여러분, 한국에서 최고가는 대학이라는 그 대학 안에 동아리들이 마약 동아리가 있다라는.
In Korea, the prestige university that are in Korea, there is gather together and do drugs. And even inside of middle school and high schools, they gather together and do drugs. And that is why we must go to the schools and heal them with the gospel.
And
these are the new answers that God is trying to give us regarding evangelism. So really pray for this. So if we lose hold of prayer, we fall into lethargy and fall into obsession, and many people, all the people will fall into addiction. That is why quickly we must restore prayer. What kind of prayer? It is not some kind of special prayer. It must become our life, our daily lives must be connected with prayer. So we must go inside of the 24-hour prayer.
기도하는 가운데서 하나님과 소통함으로 행복한 시간이 있어야 되고요.
And through prayer, we must have at the time to become happy, and we must have the time where we receive strength and answers. This isn't some kind of special time, but it must be inside of our daily lives. Everybody needs this. And right now, we have our remnants seated here with us. Our remnants, yes, your studies are very important. And how you will head out to the world is very important as well. But you guys must have the time where you're truly happy and receive strength and answers through prayer. If you do not have that time, then we have to live this world inside of the world with our own strength. And we have to follow after the world. But what happens if you follow after the world? You're just the person who's just enslaved by the world. And we fall into a lethargy or obsession and addiction. And during the evangelism school this Friday, I spoke to you about the prayer journey. And so what is this journey? It is 24, 25, and eternity. So we are receiving strength through prayer. So what is the prayer to enjoy the power? It is going inside of the prayer of 24, 25, and eternity. So in this age where people are all lethargic, obsessed, and addicted, I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you stand as the evangelist to heal those people with the gospel. Secondly, we must have the different strength, another strength through prayer. It's not my power, it's not your power, it is not the things of the world as well. We need the strength and power that is given from God. We have already received it. We just don't know it. And we are just not using that power. But the moment we become the children of God inside of Christ, we have already received this power. What is that? It is our status and authority that is given to us. And we must enjoy this through prayer. Then realistically, all of the problems inside of our lives are solved. In John 14:16-17, he tells us, "And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper to be with you forever." And what does it say in verse 17? Let us read together. "Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you."
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So it's another helper. The Holy Spirit is with us forever. He has promised that he will be with us forever. Because we lose hold of this fact, we keep on trying to do things with our own strength and power. So we don't know prayer, and we even lose hold of the gospel. The Holy Spirit told us that he will be with us. And we must heed our ears to the guidance and the protection and the grace of the Holy Spirit. And that is the first prayer that we must pray. We must lean our ears to the guidance, the protection, grace, and the teachings of the Holy Spirit. And that is the mystery to receive another strength. It is already given to us, and also tells us in Acts 1:8. "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth."
It
says the Holy Spirit will give us power. He is giving us the strength so that we can become the witnesses to the ends of the earth. That is why we go only. And if you see in the book of John, it
says,
if we have the filling of the
Holy,
if God anoints us, then there's nothing else that we need. If you see in 1 John 2:27. So we must go inside of the filling of the Holy Spirit. You must go inside of the Creator God that is given from above. And we must go inside of the God that is the ruler of our life. And go inside of God, who is the God of the judgment. And inside of God, we must be able to live our lives. And that is our prayer. So in prayer, there is the third world. And you're able to see Paul experience this third heaven. So it says the third heaven. So now we have our
air.
So there is this dome, and above that is the third heaven. And after having this spiritual experience, he prayed. So with the Word of God and the Gospel, we must first organize ourselves. And inside of that, we are able to pray. So those who are not able to pray, do it this way.
거기에서 주시는 힘을 먼저 얻으십시오.
First receive the strength that is given from the word.
그렇게 되어지면은 그 힘으로 나의 기도가 되게 돼 있습니다.
And after receiving that strength, you are able to pray. And that was the order that Paul received.
응답을 주신 것이 아니라 전부를 주셨습니다.
But God didn't give Paul the answer, but he gave him everything. And that is verse 9 today. God tells Paul, My grace is sufficient for you.
내 은혜, 하나님 안에 있는 그 은혜가 너에게 족하다 했습니다.
The grace of God, it is sufficient for you.
내 능력이 네게 머문다 했습니다.
For my power is made perfect.
여러분, 정말로 하나님의 은혜 속에 내가 있다면 끝나는 거 아닙니까?
If we have the grace of God, then isn't that over?
기도하는 바울에게 하나님은 응답을 주신 것이 아니라 하나님의 모든 것 전부를 주셨다라는 사실.
So to Paul who was praying, God didn't give him answers but gave him everything. And Paul who received these answers confesses, therefore I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses.
온전해짐이 아닌가 깨달았어.
He was able to know that the power of God is made perfect in my weaknesses. But many other people try to hide their weaknesses. Many people try to hide their weaknesses. And this one person told me, Pastor, stop saying that this is weak, I'm weak and I'm lacking. Then people, the other believers will truly look at you and say that you're weak. But all other people have their weaknesses. And people try to boast about the things that they are good at. But because of the complexes, they try to hide those. But the Paul who's truly experienced the spiritual experience, he boasted about his weakness. Because he was able to know the grace that is given inside of God. And inside of prayer, he was able to know that the power of God rests upon me in my weaknesses.
여러분, 만약 이것이 없다면은
if you do not have this,
나의 부족한 것들은 부끄러움이 되는 것이죠.
That all of the weaknesses and the things that we lack are will become an embarrassment to us.
약한 것 가운데 이길 수 있는 모든 것들을 우리에게 주셨어요.
God has already given us a power to win over everything.
먼저 그 속에 들어가야 합니다.
We must first go inside of that.
오직의 기도.
And that is only prayer.
여러분 이번 한 주간 고린도후서 1장 12장 1절에 10절 이 말씀을 한번 묵상을 해보세요.
So truly meditate upon this the passage.
반드시 도달해야 될 부분들.
It is
우리의 영적 생활에서 반드시 체험하고 누려야 될 부분들입니다.
It is the spiritual experience that we must truly enjoy. And inside of this, we are able to have victory. Really, inside of your daily lives, pray. And through restoring that prayer, bless in the name of the Lord, may you go inside of the only prayer to save everything.
우리에게 기도로 모든 것 할 수 있는 귀중한 축복의 비밀을 주셨어.
God has given us the blessing where we can receive all of the blessings through prayer.
교회적으로 24 릴레이 기도 속에 함께 인도를 받고 있습니다.
Now we are having this prayer relay.
기도하다 보면은 아 하나님 이걸 통해서 내게 이 축복을 주기 위해서 기도하게 하셨구나라는 걸 알게 돼.
You're gonna as you pray, you're able to know that oh, this is the blessing that God is trying to give me through prayer.
은혜 가운데 있기 위해서 기도하자고 시작했습니다.
We started this relay, prayer relay. But you're going to be able to see that this is a greater, that God is preparing a greater time schedule for us.
And
So if you're truly able to pray, then we're able to do everything. And I bless you in the name of the Lord. May this blessing be abundant inside of your lives and inside of the church.
오늘 찬양은 말씀하신 이가 하나님이시니 오직 기도 곡으로 찬양하겠는데요. 기도 제목들 한번 보십시다. 오직 기도의 비밀을 가진 전도 제자의 기도입니다. 같이 한번 읽어보십시다. 잃어버린 기도를 회복함으로 세상과 육신의 것으로 각인된 것 치유되게 하옵소서. 삶의 기도로 행복, 힘, 답을 얻는 시간 통해 무기력과 집착과 중독에서 빠져나오게 하옵소서. 하나님으로부터 오는 힘인 그 속에 들어가고 그 속에서 내 인생이 사라지게 하옵소서. 기도 제목들 마음 담으시고 함께 찬양하게 되겠습니다. 말씀하시니가 하나님이